Hi everyone, welcome to a new session. Today we'll look at lesson 21, Mad or Not. 大家好，今天我们学习第21课，课文的标题是 Mad or Not, 是不是疯了？ The story is about a man who lives near the airport. 故事呢，讲的是有一个人住在机场附近。Okay, first things first.Let's look at the keywords and expressions. 下面呢，我们先来看看本课中的关键词和短语。Drive somebody mad. Passing. Night and day. Come into use. Knock down. Offer. Be determined to do something.Okay, now I'm going to have you look at the questions on the text. Please keep them in mind while you watch and listen. 好，下面呢，我给大家提课文的三个问题。大家在看动漫的时候，带着问题去听。Okay, let's look at them together. Question number one. How does the writer feel about aeroplanes?
作者对飞机是什么样的感受
?Question number two. What has made most of his neighbors leave their homes?
是什么使得作者的大部分邻居都离开了自己的家
?Question number three. Why do people think the writer is mad?
为什么大家认为作者疯了
?Aeroplanes.Are slowly driving me mad. I live near an airport, and passing planes can be heard night and day. The airport was built years ago, but for some reason, it could not be used then. Last year, however, it came into use.Over 100 people must have been driven away from their homes by the noise. I am one of the few people left. Sometimes I think this house will be knocked down by a passing plane. I have been offered a large sum of money to go away. But I am determined to stay here.Everybody says I must be mad, and they are probably right.
Have you understood the story?
大家听懂了这个故事了吗？好，下面呢，我们就一起来试着回答刚才提的问题。
How does the writer feel about aeroplanes?
作者对飞机是一种什么样的感受呢？
He feels thatAeroplanes are slowly driving him mad.
作者觉得飞机正在慢慢地把他逼疯。
What has made most of his neighbors leave their homes?
是什么使得作者的大部分邻居都离家搬迁呢？
Most of his neighbors have been driven away from their homes.By the noise of the planes.
他的大部分邻居搬迁是因为飞机的噪音实在太大。
Why do people think the writer is mad?
为什么大家都认为作者疯了呢？
Because he has been offered a large sum of money to go away, but he is determined to stay.
因为曾经有人出了一大笔钱让作者搬走，但是呢，他却决定留下来。好，问答我们就先做到这儿。接下来我们看看课文中的语言点。
Aeroplanes are slowly driving me mad.
飞机正在慢慢地把我逼疯。
Drive somebody mad.
是使某人疯狂，把某人逼疯。 mad 这个词还可以用另外两个词来替代，就是 crazy 和 insane。Drive somebody crazy or drive somebody insane 都是同一个意思。下面我们来看一看 drive 这个词的用法。Over 100 people must have been driven away from their homes by the noise. 有100多人肯定是被飞机的噪音逼得离家搬迁。Have been driven away 是被动语态的现在完成时。Drive away 的意思呢，是把什么赶走。I was driven by my curiosity to look into the window. 我受好奇心的驱使，向窗子里看去。这里呢，drive 意思是驱使。What are you driving at? 你到底想说明什么？Drive at 是一个固定搭配，意思是说明什么东西。The airport was built years ago, but for some reason, it could not be used then. 飞机场是多年前建的，但是由于某种原因，当时却无法使用。For some reason 是由于某种原因。那么同样的结构呢，我们再来看看几个例子。For various reasons 由于各种各样的原因。For different reasons 由于不同的原因。For one reason or another由于这样或那样的原因。好，我们再看下一个语言点。Last year, however, it came into use. Come into use, 意思是被使用。请大家注意，形式上它虽然是主动的，但是呢，它含有被动的意味。请看这个例句。When did banknote come into use? 纸币是什么时候开始被使用的？那么 be out of use 意思就是不再被使用。比如 That telephone is out of use now. 那部电话现在已经不能用了。I am one of the few people left. 只有少数人留下来，我是其中之一。Few 这个词的意思是少数，它比 a few 在数目上还要少。请看这个例句。Very few people know this. 很少有人知道这个。Very few 在程度上指更少的人。Left 在这里呢是一个过去分词，修饰 people， 意思是剩下来的。There is nothing left， 什么也没有剩下。I have been offered a large sum of money to go away。有人出了一大笔钱，要让我离开。在这句话里边用的是被动语态，现在完成时的被动语态。要注意的是 offer 这个词是可以跟双宾语的动词，所以呢，在这个被动语态里边还保留了一个宾语的成分。我们来看一个例子。 He was given a bike on his birthday. 在他生日的那天，有人送了他一辆自行车。大家知道 give 这个词也是可以跟双宾语的 give somebody something， 那么在被动语态中呢，同样保留了一个宾语。好，我们再看下一个语言点。 But I am determined to stay here， 但我决定留下来。 Be determined to do something 意思是决定怎么做，决心做什么。在这里的意思相当于 I decided to stay here。但是它们之间的区别呢 ？Be determined to do something 有一种决心做什么事情的意思。Okay, so much for the language points. Now we'll move on to key structures and usage. 语言点讲完了，接下来我们就来看一看本课的关键句型和用法。在这里我们要讲一讲被动语态。被动语态呢是由联系动词 be 加上过去分词构成的。被动语态也可以有各种时态，那么时态呢就是体现在 be 动词上面的变化。好，下面呢我们就来看看被动语态的句子。Passing planes can be heard night and day. 来来往往的飞机日日夜夜都可以听得到。Can be heard 在这里是被动语态。The airport was built years ago, but for some reason it could not be used then.
飞机场是多年以前建的，但是由于某种原因，当时不能使用。这句话里有两个被动语态，一个是 was built， 还有一个是 could not be used。
Over 100 people must have been driven away from their homes by the noise。
有100多人肯定是被飞机的噪音逼得离家搬迁。那么这里的被动语态呢是 must have been driven away。这里呢带有 by 的动表示动作执行者的这个短语，那么有的时候呢这个 by 短语呢可以省略，也就是说不必特别强调说明动作执行者的时候 by 短语可以省略。
Sometimes I think this house will be knocked down by a passing plane.
有时候我觉得这个屋子就要被一架过往的飞机撞倒了。这里用的是被动语态的一般将来时 will be knocked down。
I have been offered a large sum of money to go away。
有人出了一大笔钱让我搬走。这里呢
have been offered
是被动语态的现在完成时，这里省略了 by 也就是动作执行者这样一个短语，所以在翻译的时候呢可以说有人怎么样。好，最后又到我们就话题说几句的时间了。课文的标题是 Mad or Not， 疯了还是没疯。那么作者到底是疯了还是没疯呢？在课文的最后，作者说
Everybody says that I must be mad, and they are probably right.
大家都说作者是疯了，而他自己也说他们也许是说的对的。显然我们可以看出作者并没有真的疯，因为你真的疯了，你就不可能承认自己是疯了。这里呢有一个悖论 paradox。 那么作者之所以留下来没有搬走，是因为做了一个非理性的决定 ，an irrational decision， an irrational decision。 做这样的决定呢，是因为出于情感的原因 ，for emotional reasons。 大家知道，有些事情你会赋予它一种感情 ，emotional attachment， emotional attachment。 当一件事物有了 emotional attachment 以后呢，它就成了你生活中不可割舍的一部分，就像一件旧东西你不舍得扔掉一样。那么对于作者来讲 to leave or to stay it's a matter of personal choice， 也就是他个人的选择了。好，话题就先说到这儿。 See you next time.